Anthony blitzes his smoked salmon mixture along with some milk.
This is a large pinch of paprika. Goodness me, it's a large pinch of that stuff anyway.
We get the idea. And with that goes seasoning, lemon juice, his gloopy salmon mixture, and gelatin, which all gets a good whisking. How's that tasting then?
Oh, abracadabra.
Is that good?
Oh, yeah.
He portions up.
Winner, winner, salmon dinner.
And into chill they go.
Much less snacks.
Quite nice, that's quite pretty.
Oh, here we come. Oh.
I am worried about this. I've never had salmon mousse before.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm going to join your little party there because I've never had it either.
But we're giving it a go.
That's the spirit. Get stuck in.
When I first read it, I was sort of, oh, it might be a bit not that exciting, but this is quite delicious. I'm really enjoying this, I gotta say.
Even though it was simple, it was executed brilliantly.
The texture was a bit snotty, like, and I did find your jellyfied bit what popped out.
Not my cup of tea, but I gave it a go.
That's good enough for me.
Didn't like it. I tried my best, but the texture just, I couldn't.
I'm not the biggest smoked salmon fan, but I've tried it and it's fine and I'm enjoying it, so thank you very much.
Oh, bless you. We're all met for the first time, but you don't know anything about me, so what do you think I do for a living?
I think you're a music teacher.
I think you're in sales of some sort.
I think that you would make a great car salesman.
Oh, I'm wounded.
Defo not a car salesman. If he tried to sell me a car, I'd probably walk out the showroom.
I am the amazing Anthony, multi-award winning mind reader and magician and tarot reader.
Wow. No, exciting! Oh, he's a mind reader? That's amazing!
And that's why I'm the amazing Anthony. Well done, Hannah! Yay. Yay.
Well, yeah, I can't believe that Anthony does that. I didn't see that coming.
You're not a mind reader then.
Oh my God. Stop thinking bad thoughts.
Are you a bit of a Nostradamus? You can predict things?
I've predicted a few things successfully. I got the lottery numbers twice, once live on stage, and then more recently, I had a two-day sellout show at the Madam Market Theatre in Norwich.
I think it's a load of bunkum. I don't buy that. He guessed the lottery results. No, I don't. Why would he be here?
If that was me and I was a mind reader, or I could predict the future or anything like that, I'd be sitting in a mansion, wouldn't I?
Anyone want to give Anthony a run for his money?
Right, I'm reading your mind. I think that you are thinking your starter may be better than Anthony's.
Oh! You're thinking about work.
No, I was thinking, I really hope I haven't got lipstick on my teeth.
Well, I'm liking Hannah. I am feeling it. She can come out with some strange stuff sometimes and quite over-dramatic. But I'm wondering, the more the week goes on, the more she might start to get a bit louder.
I'm going to give each of you one of these boards and a pen. Mm-hmm. And you're going to write down, unbeknownst to me, a guilty secret. But at the end of that, I will attribute each guilty secret correctly to each of you. Now, does that sound mind-bendingly amazing?
Amazing. Yes.
Oh, wow. Amazing. Fabulous. Thank you, darling.
Right, you lot. Let's have your guilty secrets by all means, but for heaven's sake, let's keep it clean.
Keep the boards face down so you don't know who's written what, and shuffle them. With the first board, I will ask each of you the same question. You will all say no. I've been stopped by the police for weeing in a doorway.
No.
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 You're just happy to be here. You're just... But you two ladies, there's a bit of a different vibe. You could almost be this person. So, Sarah, I believe I've been stopped by the police, a pin in the doorway is you.
Yes! He did get it right. Or do I just look like that sort of person who'd wee in a doorway and get called by a policeman?
I'm saying nothing.
Didn't you do the worm on the limo floor? You did, didn't you?
I did the worm on the limo floor!
I know the person who had wished they'd skydive when they were choice was you.
Yes!
Yay!
Well done!
I'm sitting there thinking, how'd you do that, mate? Tell me your tricks.
Got a ticket from a policeman for arguing with a bouncer when I was a teenager.
That's good.
Well done. Yeah.
Anthony definitely is a bit of a showman, a character. He definitely seems to know how to capture someone's attention.
They were the right sort of people for an audience to do it, and it was a good laugh for everybody, and it gave me a very good idea of what I can do. No, I like dad jokes.
Oh, no, please.
And I like them just like that. Or just like that.
Dad joke part two.
I'm leaving. Was that it?
What did he got
you do? I didn't recognise Anthony's dad joke, to tell you the truth. His dad joke was just as bad as yesterday's.
Do you want to see my Tommy Cooper impression just like that? Or do you want to see it just like that? Because I'm very happy to be here, and I'm very happy to be here as well.
Oh, God, I don't like the dad thing. No, I think he's just not to say anything at all.
Hannah?
No, I don't find Anthony funny at all.
Well, he's here all week. Bad luck.
So I hope you've all enjoyed the main course. Thank you very much. And if you'd like to follow me, I have a little bit of surprise for you outside.
Oh, stonking!
So we've got a minute to see as... to eat as many donuts as we possibly can with our hands behind our back. So, Anthony, if you could be our timekeeper this evening.
Okay.
Oh. Assume your position. 3, 2, 1, go.
Jess, get stuck in. Come on.
The donut game is brilliant.
Go on, get in there.
I was doing this. I just couldn't get a bite. Do you have to spit it out or can you swallow it?
Oh, can I get it?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
The technique I used was just try and get the donut. It kept on swinging.
She's not doing it when it's...
I'm sorry. At one point, Luke nearly bit Sarah.
Keep going.
Oh, I can't breathe. Let her get through.
She does it.
A nightmare. But no, that was, I will say, that was really quite good fun.
Time's up, ladies and gents. The winner is Dangerous Luke.
I ate a lot of donuts. Quite full.
I just hope that they can eat their pudding now.
Out with her desserts.
I know these look good at the moment. They're all perfectly set, but I just need to glam it up, add a bit of me with a little bit of edible glitter.
So she sprinkles and dots on raspberries.
Just need a bit more glitter. Never can have enough glitter.
Agreed. And it's on with the bickies.
Now for my final touch of glitz and glamour.
And they are done. Lemon mousse with homemade shortbread and even more glitter.
I hope you all enjoy.
So what do we do with these? Do we stick them in it?
You can stick them in it. Eat it however you like, Sarah.
Oh, I like it.
It hasn't got like a mousse texture. It feels more thicker than that, but it's still very lemony and it's beautiful.
Oh, I do love a lemony dessert.
Lemony, lemon essence, lemon posset. Lemony lovely.
Yeah.
Dessert was fantastic. It wasn't as I expected. It was more a posset, and it had a lingering flavour of lemon.
Maybe not a mousse, but it's delicious. It's like a panna cotta almost.
Yes.
That's the word.
Shortbread's great. I love it.
Shortcake can be quite dry, can't it? And like, got to wash it down with a cup of tea to get it out of your mouth. It was perfect.
What do you think about the edible glitter? Do you think it'll leave a little bit of sparkle and shine on you?
Defo.
I'm waiting to see me poo. I bet it does.
Oh, my God!
Anthony! We need some decorum. Hannah!
One of the things that I can do is I can put my whole fist in my whole mouth.
No!
Do it.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, well, I reckon anyone could do that.
Amazing and incredible. Oh, and it's true. I'm under... It is all happening.
Oh, my God. That is... I think it's time to go home.
Dessert went really well. They likened it to a panna cotta, but I thought it was mousse to me. I feel it was a winning dinner party. If I had to rate myself out of 10, I would definitely give myself a glamorous, glitzy 9.
So you might have gathered from my menu that I am Adele tonight. From the A Delicious Focaccia.
Jess does. When you think about it, she does look a bit like Adele.
Wait till you hear her sing.
Is Adele performing later?
Wait and see.
Oh, you tease. That sounds like a yes to me.
Should we guess who we are?
Let's give it a go, shall we?
I'm getting 9 to 5. Dolly Parton over there.
Never.
Yeah.
Great guess. Well done. Woo-hoo.
Great effort tonight.
Thank you.
Was Dolly Parton there? I mean, I was there from 9 to 5, but I didn't notice.
Oh, Anthony.
Does anyone know who Sarah is?
Well, I was thinking Morticia Adams.
Oh, my God.
I'm sorry, but she's not a singer, but I think you look amazing.
It's Cher. It's Cher.
Oh, of course it's Cher.
Which brings us to Dangerous Luke.
Mr. Pink.
Mr. Pink?
In that person?
Who's Mr. Pink?
Because your pink jacket, Mr. Pink. Is he not
also
a singer?
I feel like you've just made that up.
For me, Mr. Pink's from Reservoir Dogs, and he never wore something like this. This is Mr. Pink.
Bruno Mars?
Absolutely.
Oh, it's so obvious now.
Yeah. Luke obviously looks like Bruno Mars. I thought it from day one. I was just thinking pink jacket, maybe a gold chain, and then he come tonight. Incredible. Who do we think Anthony is?
I haven't got a foggiest clue, but I'm just going Frank Sinatra.
No. Aww.
No.
Think of the world of musicals.
What about Fred Astaire?
It's not. I knew it'd be a challenge. Stubby K.
Never heard of him.
No, that was a... That was...
Not sure they're massive Guys and Dolls fans, Anthony.
Even when Anthony did the reveal of Stubby K, I'm sorry, I just didn't know who it was. I thought it was another dad joke.
Not this time.
As a young female, don't ever say a big...
Yeah, probably good
big
point.
Big fruit.
Big fruit, yeah. When I realised what I'd done, I just felt awful. I just felt like an idiot. I didn't know how to get out of it.
Move it on. Someone else's turn.
Sarah, I've got you as a...
Oh,
red...
God, what have you got me as?
I've got you as a red onion because you're... because you're sweet and you've got lots of different layers.
I haven't got lots of different layers.
You have.
There's
you're...
only one layer.
No,
isn't
you turn
there?
Out.
There is only one layer of Sarah.
I'm quite offended by that.
When I complimented Sarah about being a red onion because it's sweet with many layers, that was great.
I'm not sure it was.
I know I'm quite funny in that, but that is a bit of an insult, an onion.
Luckily, Jess has a more appealing surprise in the garden.
As you guys have come, all dressed up as your favourite pop star, I would love for you to sing a couple of lines from a favourite song of theirs. I'm going to kick this off with Adele.
Yeah! Of course she is! Never in doubt.
When the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case.
Jess was really good. She really blew me away. She sounded like Adele.
To make you feel my love. Woo! Yeah! Woo!
Amazing.
Yeah,
well done.
Go on in, Bruno. Show us what you got.
Uptown Funk's gonna give it to you. Uptown Funk's gonna give it to you. Uptown Funk's gonna give it to you. Saturday night, something, something.
That was not singing. It was shouting with style.
He had us all up laughing. Yeah, that was terrible.
Come on!
I'm having like a Vicar of Dibley moment here. I just want to stick my head in it.
A good drizzle of chalk at the bottom.
There we go. It's ready.
And there it is. Save the best for last. Raspberry sorbet with a chocolate waffle cone upside down. I've seen it all now.
Ooh, look at that.
Enjoy.
That's not a good face.
It was a bit sharp, isn't it? I was like, I really, you know, George, your buttocks up to you, like, it's like...
A nice, strong raspberry flavour. I'm not sure it's my absolute cup of tea.
The dessert was rather tart. Oh, yes, it was. Oh, yes.
I think the sorbet is, it's a little bit tart.
Dessert didn't go down very well. I've let myself down. Yeah, it was too sharp.
Quick, someone lighten the mood.
No. Oh, Anthony, you look like a cone head.
In the bedroom.
Oh. Are these the remains of people? I think it is. I'm assuming maybe...
Mum and Dad?
Possibly.
We all love our parents. Dearly, but I don't think I'd really want their ashes in my bedroom.
Bit creepy.
Ghosts of the parents.
Watching over the bedroom.
I'd feel like they were always looking over, not just your shoulder, but like while you were sleeping. It feels a bit creepy.
I'm feeling a bit creeped out. Yeah. I think we should get out of here.
True.
Bye, Michael. Bye, Jill.
It's beautiful.
Really?
Really nice. Oh, my God. There's so many flavours in it. It's great.
Thank you so much.
Is that like a red currant sauce or something?
It's my little secret ingredient, a bit of strawberry jam.
Oh.
Yeah.
Never heard of strawberry jam in a stuffed pepper, but I have to say it actually did work.
They were very surprised, weren't they, about my strawberry jam? I think if I'd asked them to really, really guess it and guess, they would have never got it, would they?
That's the sweet flavour, isn't it? Because I can really taste the garlic, which is lovely, but then the jam makes it the sweetness.
Yeah.
I was quite impressed with the starter. However, I would have liked them to have been stuffed with maybe minced lamb, minced beef.
Not strawberry jam, then.
Just a bit more heat, but I love all the mix and the flavours and the different textures. It's really different and it's really nice. Thank you.
Good. They said they enjoyed it and everyone ate more than what I did, you know? So I'm really, I couldn't have gone any better, could it, really?
Yeah, it's all going well so far.
So we had a little tour of your house.
Oh, yeah. A little poke around. We found what I think were the remains of some loved ones.
Remains?
Maybe?
Who's up there? Who you found?
I think they're the ashes of someone.
Oh, you must have bumped into my mum and dad up there.
Jill and Michael?
Yeah, that's that. How are they doing up there?
They're all right.
I just thought, is this real? Are they making this up? It was just really, really strange, really bizarre.
Well, they're right there next to your bed, so they're viewing you at all times, I guess.
Yeah. Got to keep an eye on me, haven't they?
Can I ask why it's next door to your bed?
I feel like I don't want them, put them anywhere else, so...
Okay.
Why can't people understand that I'd like mum and dad in the bedroom, you know? Is that normal, innit? I'm sure lots of other people have their mum and dad in the bedroom when they're dead.
Not sure they do.
I might have a little seance sometimes and I'll get them all out and I'll put them on the living room table and he'll get up in the morning and he's like, oh, my God, you've been at it again, haven't you? You know?
What happens with your seances?
The last time I did it, and the TV started going on and off, and I thought it was my husband, right, with, like, the remote control. I was like, Kevin, what are you doing? Yeah. Stop it! And I turned around, looked on the table, and they were both sitting there, the remote controls. There's no word of a lie.
I don't believe it. I think it might have been a power cut.
And then I had this really calming feeling come over me. It was amazing.
Like, unless I was there and I saw it, I don't really believe in that sort of thing.
We've had things where we've been in the lounge and the cat and the dog are both at the same moment looked towards the set, and we've seen a shadow go up the stairs.
Really?
And our house is on ground that used to be consecrated land.
Anthony, hey, trying to steal my night, you know? Trust him to have a ghost as well, you know? It's my night. Not his night.
Really?
That used to be part of Wyndham Abbey.
Yeah.
It subsequently became the Britain Brush Factory, but the road that you came in at the top marks the furthest extent of the Abbey, and the Abbey was founded in the 1100s.
Yeah.
You all right, Hannah?
I just turn off when Anthony talks now. It's just getting worse and worse, more boring as the week goes on.
Stuff at our house we just think's benign. We don't feel any threat at all. Stuff occasionally disappears. And Maxine and I recently, last couple of years, decided we just asked the spirit of the house. Yeah. We'd like that book. We need it. Can we have it back? It's part of my routine. The following day it appears.
No, Anthony's misplaced the book and then just blamed it on a spirit.
But evidently there's a very strict library policy that the spirits are keeping to in Anthony's house.
So, who's up for playing a game of pin the organ on the body, blindfolded?
Is this how you pass your medical
training? This is exactly how we all do it. Yeah. You don't play this game, you don't pass medical school. Who wants to go first?
Me!
All right. Yeah. Right, so this is the first organ. Okay. This is your organ. I'm not going to tell you what it is. Here you go.
Oh! If I can't put this on?
Yeah.
And my lashes!
Come on. We stuck on it.
Just put it where you think it should go.
Well, I think it might be the gallbladder.
No, but it's a good guess. What do you think it could be?
Stomach.
There you go.
Oh, well, no, it's on the boobies.
I got it totally wrong, but I was blindfolded and I was more worried about my eyelashes than where the stomach went.
Where does it go? Oh.
Good effort.
Yeah.
Good effort.
There you go.
I'm sure we all wear a heart on our sleeve.
I did enjoy that, yeah. It was quite funny to see where some people think organs belong.
Jess wants to go next.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Where are we?
That's cheating.
No, it's not.
Cheating.
No, it's not.
As you can see, I'm sure of it. That is cheating.
Jess got it bang on, but I think that she sneaked a look through that blindfold.
Well, that's Anthony's turn now.
Ooh, I don't know about there. Ooh.
I'm not sure if you have the orientation of the liver correct, but other than that, it's pretty good.
You said I got it in the right place, just had the organ the wrong way round. Well, that's not bad, is it? The patient would have lived.
The winner of the giant size forceps is Jess.
Yay! I got 100% out of 100%, so I'm now a qualified doctor. Yeah, brain surgeon.
Pudding, please. On goes the pastry lid, and it's into bake. Once cooked...
That's nice, that's perfect.
It's ta-ta-ta tipping time.
A little nervous. OK.
Drum roll, please. Ta-da!
Huge relief.
Nailed it! And after a cheeky lick,